This report looks at whether the government of BC and the Ministry of Forests, Lands, and Natural Resource Operations are effectively managing impacts from natural resource development that add up over time, causing changes to the environment. These changes are referred to as cumulative effects. As a nonpartisan, independent auditor of the Legislative Assembly, the Auditor General audits a government reporting entity. This consists of ministries, crown corporations, and other government organizations, such as universities, colleges, school districts, health authorities, and similar organizations that are controlled by or accountable to the provincial government. The Office of the Auditor General serves the people of British Columbia and their elected representatives by conducting independent audits and advising on how well government is managing its responsibilities and resources. Under the Auditor General Act, the Auditor General conducts and reports on both financial audits and performance or value for money audits. BC has a long history of natural resource development: forestry, mining, oil, natural gas, and hydroelectric. It is an important sector of the BC economy, one which government intends significant growth, particularly for mining and natural gas development. Government has stated it is their responsibility to develop the economy in an environmentally sustainable manner. Sustainable development in the natural resource sector requires careful consideration of environmental impacts and cumulative effects. Natural resource development in BC is regulated and managed to limit and mitigate its environmental impacts. However, residual impacts, that is, effects expected to remain even after mitigation, can combine and have a greater effect than any one individual activity could, hence the term cumulative effects. Simply put, cumulative effects are impacts from human activity, such as natural resource development, that add up over time, causing changes to the environment. If not carefully managed, cumulative effects can damage ecological systems that are essential to our well-being, systems that stabilize our climate and provide clean air, water, and other renewable natural resources, like forests. We conducted this audit to determine whether the Government of BC and the Ministry of Forests, Lands, and Natural Resource Operations have established a sound basis for managing cumulative effects to the environment. We did this by assessing whether 1. The Government of BC and the Ministry have established clear direction and responsibilities for managing cumulative effects. 2. The Ministry is considering and addressing cumulative effects in its decision making, as demonstrated by recent activity in the Northwest region of BC. And 3. The Ministry is working to improve cumulative effects management. The Ministry is the province's designated one land manager that authorizes most natural resource use. Therefore, we expected the Ministry to coordinate the management of cumulative effects with BC's other natural resource sector ministries and agencies. We found that no existing legislation or other government directives explicitly requires the Ministry of Forests, Lands, and Natural Resource Operations or any other government ministry or agency to manage cumulative effects when authorizing the use of natural resources. Natural resource ministries and agencies may carry out their mandates without considering the impacts of other natural resource ministries and agencies. We found that the Ministry collaborates with other natural resource sector entities to coordinate and streamline the processing and assessment of natural resource development proposals, but not for managing cumulative effects. We also found that the Ministry has not provided staff responsible for making natural resource use decisions with guidance and training on cumulative effects management. From a selection of land use plans and related material that we reviewed for the Skeena region of BC, the area of our audit, we concluded Ministry decision makers had not adequately evaluated resource development proposals for cumulative effects. Government has not provided decision makers with information that they need to manage cumulative effects, That information includes values that define what is important to manage for, the condition of those values, and the amount of change to values that is deemed acceptable. These gaps in information make it difficult for decision makers to interpret risk and make informed decisions about their development proposals. We found that the Ministry has developed a cumulative effects assessment framework to support cumulative effects management and help BC's natural resource ministries make informed decisions that are consistent with the government's intent to balance economic development with protection of our environment. The assessment framework will be phased in and not fully implemented until 2021. Decisions about natural resource development continue to be made without fully understanding the implications. This framework has the potential to improve cumulative effects management, but at the time of our audit, neither ministry staff nor government had resolved how the framework will be used to inform and support natural resource development decisions across natural resource sector, ministries, and agencies. As a result of these conclusions, we made 4 recommendations to government and 5 recommendations to the Ministry of Forest, Lands, and Natural Resource Operations. Recommendations for government are aimed at establishing tools, such as legislation and policy, to support cumulative effects management across natural resource sector ministries and agencies. They include clarifying how its social, economic, and environmental expectations apply to managing Crown land, and establishing how assessments resulting from the cumulative effects framework will be used to inform and support natural resource development decisions. Recommendations for the Ministry are aimed at developing and supporting effective and transparent cumulative effects management within the Ministry, and ensuring the successful implementation of the cumulative effects assessment framework. Addressing cumulative effects management will help government achieve its social, economic, and environmental objectives for sustainable natural resource development. This concludes our summary of this report. We'd like to thank the Ministry of Forest, Lands, and Natural Resource Operations for their cooperation with this audit. To read this report and our other publications, or for more information about our office, please visit our website at www.bcauditor.com.